Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Our lecture today about RH isoimmunization, erythroblastosis fetalis, hydrops fetalis. Basic blood group type, group A, non-VABO, O. Group A, surface antigen A. Group B, surface antigen B. Antigen A and B. Or neither A or B. So, our subject in this lecture is to know the AB incompatible, ABO, and RH negative. Hemolytic disease of the newborn may be due to AB or incompatible fetus inheritance one gene from each parent, O plus O, O plus A, O or A, O plus B, O or B, O plus AB, O or AB. This about blood group. About RH blood group system, first demonstrated in rhesus monkey, blood group are classified as RH negative or RH positive. RH blood group system, the genotype is determined by inheritance of three pairs of closely linked allele genes situated on chromosome 9, named as D, C, E. RH blood group system, the fetus inherited one gene from each group as a haplotype, such as set of CDE, CD small letter, from each parent. 12 set of combination and 78 genotype are possible. Most frequent genotype, this show below, and about everyone the percentage will show in this slide. RH isoimmunization is an immunological disease that occurs in pregnancy, resulting in a serious complication affecting the fetus or the neonate, ranging from mild neonatal jaundice to intrauterine loss or neonatal death, according to affected fetus. This immunological disease occurs when the RH-negative patient carrying a RH-positive fetus. يعني المادر تكون RH-negative والفيتاس RH-positive. This is called RH isoimmunization. Had a fetal maternal blood transfusion, the mother immunological system is stimulated to produce antibodies to the RH antigen on the fetal blood cell. These antibodies cross the placenta and destroy the fetal RBC, lead to fetal anemia. Usually, the first fetus will not be affected if this is the first time that the mother has been exposed to the RH positive blood group of the fetus. During pregnancy, while the fetus is still in utero, the bilirubin in the fetal blood will be removed by the placenta to the maternal circulation, and part of it go to the liquor. The fetus will be anemic. If the degree of anemia is severe, fetus may die in utero because of the heart failure. After delivery, the neonate will be affected and will cause severe jaundice and anemia, and the degree of the anemia according to the fetal RBC destruction. Also, the amount of the bilirubin or jaundice according to the fetus RBC affected. Pathogenesis of the RH isoimmunization. If RH mother blood group Rh negative, the husband or man Rh positive, if homogeneous or heterogeneous. If homogeneous, the fetus Rh positive. Rh positive RBC enter the maternal circulation. When enter the maternal circulation will lead to previously sensitized second immune response and or non-sensitized mother primary immune response. First baby usually escape and mothers gets baby not affected. If previously sensitized second immune response, IgM and IgG antibody will form and may lead to affect the fetus in subsequent pregnancy or in this pregnancy in advanced gestational age and lead to hemolysis. What's mean previous sensitized? Maybe the mother will abort it first pregnancy, second pregnancy, 2 or 3 months or 4 months, and she is not known her blood group is Rh negative and the baby may be Rh positive, so the antibody will form. If the Rh negative woman and man Rh positive heterogeneous, either fetus positive or negative. If negative, no problem. Fetus. If positive, also the same process will occur previous slide. In utero, what happened to the fetus? Antigen antibody, sorry, this is a picture of erythroblastosis fetalis. In utero, antigen antibody reaction on the RBC surface lead to hemolysis, and this hemolysis will subsequently develop anemia and increase in hepatic erythropoiesis and dysfunction. Portal and umbilical vein hypertension and heart failure and lead to either erythroblastosis fetalis as the picture show or intrauterine death or polyhydramnia, increased amount of the fetus, generalized edema of the fetus, head, abdomen, heart, ascites, edema of the below the skin. After birth, antigen antibody reaction on the RBC surface, hemolysis also, anemia, jaundice, carnectoras, and neonatal death, if severe type of jaundice and destruction. Management of Rh negative pregnant women, management of non-sensitized pregnant and of sensitized pregnant, according to the presentation of the pregnant female. Management of non-sensitized pregnant. Non-sensitized Rh negative mother married to Rh positive husband, blood group typing at the first visit. If negative, check husband blood group typing. If husband is also Rh negative, then no Rh complication and manage as other pregnant women. No problem in this case. Both of them is Rh negative, so the antibody not develop in the mother's circulation. If husband is Rh positive, then starting complication. If Rh has positive, then check for maternal antibody by indirect comb test. If antibody detected, treat as sensitized mother. If no antibody repeated, indirect comb test at 28-32 week, provided that no bleeding. If there is bleeding, then before 20 week of gestation. Any bleeding occur during pregnancy, first, second, third trimester may be lead to formation of antibody in the maternal circulation, and this will attack the this fetus or new fetus. Check for fetal RBC in the maternal circulation by Kleihauer test. Check of maternal antibodies by indirect comb test. If negative, give 200 50 international unit per 50 microgram NTD to the mother within 72 hours from the bleeding. Yani once, if the pregnant woman is Rh negative and the fetus will not recognize her blood group, Rh negative, Rh positive, according to the father or mother. So we give the mother and the patient develop vaginal bleeding in this period, should be give her prophylactic NTD within 72 hours from the bleeding. Bleeding after 20 weeks of gestation, check for fetal RBC in maternal circulation by Kleihauer test, and also give maternal antibody, check for indirect COMTS test. If negative, give 500 international units, so doubling of the dose. Why? Because the increased size of the fetus increase the amount of amniotic fluid, maybe RBC will increase in number, and destruction will more occur in the 28 week, 32 week, according to the gestational age. The dose should be doubled or tripled if the fetal RBC are more than 80%, 80 cells in maternal circulation. This cell we collected from the or detected from Kleihauer test. Prophylactic management of non-sensitized pregnant during antenatal period. Prophylactic 500 international units of NTD are recommended to be given to all negative non-sensitized mother married to Rh positive husband at 28 week and 34 week. Why we give her in this period? To protect and overcome any asymptomatic or not or unnoticed antenatal fetal maternal blood transfusion. Another indication for prophylaxis at 28 week to Rh negative non-sensitized woman whose husband is Rh positive postpartum, if the woman remain non-sensitized and delivery Rh positive fetus following amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling following evacuation of the molar pregnancy or termination of pregnancy, following an ectopic pregnancy, following an abruptio placenta, or undiagnosed uterine vaginal bleeding. Another indication or prophylactic moment of non-sensitized pregnancy, failure of prophylaxis, dose too small, dose too late, more than 72 hours, patient already immunized by antibody, titer too low for laboratory recognized, defective immunoglobulin given. And what about the management of non-sensitized pregnant? Precautions should be taken to prevent the possibility of increased chance of fetal maternal blood transfusion at birth. During labor, no fundal pushing in first or second stage of labor. No uterine massage or uterine grasp and squeeze in the third stage. Let the placenta deliver spontaneously. Avoid avulsion of the cord, protect the vaginal and perineal wound, and laceration from the exposed from being exposed to fetal RBC spilled from the cord of the fetus. During cesarean section, use abdominal pack in the side of the uterus before opening the lower segment to prevent spilled blood from the placenta to enter the peritoneal cavity. Let the placenta to be delivered spontaneously using controlled cord traction without squeezing the uterus. Avoid avulsion of the cord. At birth, maternal blood sample for antibodies by indirect COMT test, fetal RBC in maternal circulation must be detected by Kleihauer test. Cord blood sampling from the neonate for antibody by direct COMT test, infant blood group, infant bilirubin level, and hemoglobin and HCT level. If fetal blood group is Rh positive, no antibody detected, give full dose of NTD to mother within 72 hours after delivery. The dose should be corrected according to the number of fetal RBC present in the maternal circulation. Do not give anti-G if the fetal blood group is Rh negative and if antibody not if antibody detected. Sensitize Rh negative mother. Causes of sensitization: misinterpretation of the maternal Rh type, Rh positive blood transfusion, unprotected pregnancy and labor, inadequate dose of anti-G in a previous occasion or previous pregnancy. A factor affecting immunization and the severity of the Rh isoimmunization: amount of antigen, host factor, integrity of maternal immune system, strength of antigen, antigenicity, influence of ABO group, ABO incompatible, and Rh positive cell will be hemolyzed before Rh antigen can be recognized by the mother immune system. About the sensitized Rh negative mother, check quantitative antibody level and first visit. In the first visit, recheck the level every 2 weeks. Serial ultrasound monitoring every 2 weeks. If antibody level continue at the same level, and no fetal compromise, delivery at term. If antibody levels start to increase, arrange for amniocentesis and spectrophotometer to study the optical density of the amniotic fluid, and that mean bilirubin level, which reflect RBC hemolysis. Ultrasound scan evaluation of the fetal well-being, and use Lilly chart curve to detect or determine the fetal condition. So we mentioned in advanced slided as zone 1 and 2, 3, and optic density of bilirubin, which show in this slide. Ultrasound finding help in fetal monitoring and timing of the first intervention of NTG level. If more than 10 international units per ml, so ultrasound can detect fetal skin and scalp edema, fetal ascites, fetal pericardial and pleural effusion, polyhydramnion, fetal hepatosplenomegaly, fetal cardiomegaly, placental hypertrophy and enlargement, abnormal fetal posture, body states. This ultrasound finding are this fluid in all the body of the fetus, it's in abdomen. Amniocentesis is an indirect method to measure the degree of hemolysis of the fetal RBC by measuring the concentration of bilirubin in the amniotic fluid. Amniotic fluid sample taken and sent for spectrophotometer, where optic density of the fluid changes according to the amount of bilirubin concentration. So, increase of density and optic density as the pregnancy advances show worsening of the fetal hemolytic disease. This is the maneuver of amniocentesis. For سحب السائل amniotic fluid from the amniotic sac by a syringe or any tube. This is Lilly chart. In this layer, from the 0.1 to 0.07, this is the zone 1. Zone 2, from 0.7 to till 0.9 and above will mean the zone 3. This 3 zone determine the severity of affected fetus. If the fetus cross the first zone, second zone, the complication will more be and hemolysis more advanced. Management of sensitized pregnancy: term pregnancy, mild or severe affected delivery, susceptibility of the place and its facility, experience of the team, type of delivery, if vaginal or abdominal, medication given, phototherapy, and extrauterine blood exchange for the fetus. preterm fetus with zone 1 Lily chart, cordocentesis and blood sampling HP, if HP 10 gram per deciliter, no ultrasound scan evidence of hydrops changes, consider conservative management with regular follow-up of fetal and maternal condition till the fetal lung maturity is assured, and then delivery will occur. Daily maternal clinical assessment, fetal movement chart, daily cardiotocograph, assessment of fetal well-being, serial ultrasound and fetal growth, biophysical profile, regular checkup of amniotic fluid, and repeated amniocentesis every 2 weeks to enhance until lung maturity and delivery of the baby will occur. Regular checkup of fetal heart HP and hematocrit value if the facilities is available, delivery will occur. Preterm fetus with zone 2 or 3, cordocentesis and blood sampling HP less than 10 gram per deciliter, fetus will develop anemia. Ultrasound evidence of hydrops changes to consider, transfer to suitable place, and intrauterine therapy starting, and delivery and extrauterine management and exchange of blood transfusion of the fetus will occur to prevent jaundice and carnivores. Another medication used, intrauterine dexamethasone to enhance lung maturity, clinical assessment and cardiotocograph, ultrasound, biophysical profile, consider repeated intrauterine blood transfusion, and if lung maturity was occur, delivery should be done. Another method of treatment here, intrauterine therapy, intraperitoneal blood transfusion through umbilical vein, cordocentesis, 80% of packed RBC or ORH negative blood cross match against maternal blood group, free of infection and fresh. This is the criteria of the blood will transfuse for intrauterine fetus. Cordocentesis from the umbilical cord, this intrauterine, we do either exchange of blood transfusion or take sampling for HB and bilirubin level. This is the last picture, is fetoscope, and to determine the cordocentesis and how to do a blood transfusion. Thank you for listening.